and I will request
Krishna Kumar.
I will request Mr. Krishna Kumar to come over to the dais for the presentation.
Rose come in, sir. ये दोनों नहीं है.
Hello. Please come over the next speaker, Mr. Krishna Kumar.
ये BSIP के हैं. And already we are late. So
yes,
try,
sir,
try to be within
good
time.
Good afternoon, everyone. I am Firoz from Birbal San Institute of Paleo Sciences, Lucknow. And at this moment, we will be discussing about the paleontological perspective of understanding climate change in India over the last two millennia. So the vegetation, as we know that vegetation is one of the main climatic reservoirs of the earth, and the global distribution and composition of vegetation is primarily governed by the climate, especially precipitation and temperature, soil characteristics and altitude. However, natural and human impacts are always there. The effect of vegetation on the climate on vegetation is so great that each climatic zone has its own characteristic vegetation type. Simultaneously, the climate change is most evidently reflected in the vegetation, because vegetation of an area is an integral and basic composition of the ecosystem, and which means the vegetation is governed by the climate change. So understanding vegetation-based climate change is one of the most indispensable aspects. And we also know that climate change is a defining issue of our time, and we have geological, biological, archaeological, historical proxy records which provide evidence of the ways in which the Earth's climate has changed, of course in the past, and how may do so in the future. So among the biological proxies, paleontology is one of the most potent tools to understand vegetation-based climate change. So here is the vegetation map of India, and there are 16 different types of vegetation according to Champion and Sett 1968. This is the Köppen system of classification of India, which shows 9 types of climate in India. So these things we have right now discussed, and because of time limitation, we have skipped all these slides. So if we talk of climate change over the past 2 millennia, it can be better discussed with the global climatic events that encompasses DACP, MCA, LIA, and current warm period. However, the Roman warm period, RWP, the later phase of this Roman warm period fall in the time frame ever around 2000 years before present. That's why I have incorporated it in the present discussion. So these are the study sites. The study sites that we have chosen for the present discussion and for the review: the Central India, the Western and Eastern Himalaya, Northeast India, and Darjeeling Himalaya also. So if you see the how pollen is playing an important role to understand the vegetation dynamics and contemporary climate change. So we have collected a 90 centimeter deep profile, and we are discussing about climate change in global climatic scenario. So if we see this paleontological profile, 90 centimeter profile from Mahasamund district of Chhattisgarh state, and we see the change in the frequency of arboreal and non-arboreal taxa. So with this study, we recovered the palynomorphs. These are the tree taxa. These are herbaceous elements. This is poaceae. Here is poaceae. Here is cerealia. There are some algal and fungal spores. Some marshy taxa also. So based on these, we have found that around 2.5 to 1.6 thousand years before present, mixed tropical deciduous forest occupied the landscape under warm and humid climate and increased monsoon precipitation. So this phase is globally correlated with the Roman warm period. So this mixed tropical deciduous forest is transformed into open mixed tropical deciduous forest between 1.6 to 9.5 kilo year before present, under a warm and relatively less humid climate and reduced monsoon rainfall. This is this climatic event shows the dark ages cold period. And again, this open mixed tropical deciduous forest is transformed to mixed tropical deciduous forest under warm and relatively more humid climate and increased monsoon rainfall, which is globally correlated with the medieval warm period, which is also known as medieval climate anomaly. So in medieval warm period and medieval climate anomaly were correlated with the different study sites that were earlier studied by me and some other people also, especially here by me. And this shows the global correlation and asynchronous phase, because the time phases varied. This is the just to show how the time frame at different sites varied with respect to the site from Mahasamund district and the different parts of central India, and also from the Himalaya. Similarly, we have also studied the another profile from southeastern Madhya Pradesh, from Kiktiha Swahamp, Shahdol district, and we have generated this pollen diagram. And based on this, we have these are the palynomorphs recovered, and between 1.6 to 700 kilo years, 700 years before present, warm and moist climate was there around the study area, and the monsoon was increased at that time. That is globally correlated with the medieval climate anomaly. Similarly, subsequently, between 7,000 to 300 years before present, the mixed deciduous forest came into existence and replaced the sal forest, and the climate was harsh, and that falls with the LIA. In another study by Kumar and Chauhan from Hoshangabad district, southwestern Madhya Pradesh, we have collected a 1.4 meter deep profile, and these are this is the pollen diagram which we had constructed. And based on the changes in the arboreal and non-arboreal taxa, we have find the different pollen assemblage, and based on that, we have tried to correlate the findings between 1.4 to 506 kilo years before present. Medieval warm period was there, and because the climate was humid and open mixed tropical deciduous forest was growing around the study area, which was replaced by a bit harsher climate and almost mixed tropical deciduous forest between 506 to 120 cal years before present. And this phase is globally correlated with the LIA, Little Ice Age. In another study, we have found from the Korba district of Chhattisgarh, we have seen the changes in the vegetation at different time scale, and we found that the signatures of MWP MCA and the current warm period, that is around 1800 AD to present around the study area. In another study, we have seen from the Bemetra district of Chhattisgarh, we found the gradual changes in the vegetation. Here we may see how the vegetation has improved with the different time span. And based on this finding, we have tried to, we suggested that during the late Holocene, the monsoon increased, and between 2.6 to 1.8 kilo years before present, the influence of RWP was there around the study area. Similarly, from Northeast India, the paleontological study was conducted by Dikshit and Behra, and here also the changes in the vegetation was recorded, and based on that they infer the MWP and the LIA between 1.5 to 5.4 years before present, the MCA, and 5.4 to present the Little Ice Age, because the sal forest that was growing in this in the landscape around the study area is transformed into mixed forest. Again, in another study, they have studied a profile from Northeast India, and they have constructed this pollen diagram. And between 1.9 to 900 calyears before present, the mixed tropical deciduous forest occurred in the region, and the climate was warm and humid, which corresponds with the MWP or MCA. And the deterioration of tropical forest happened under a warm and relatively dry climate since 989 calyears before present, which shows the harsher climate, and that corresponds with the Little Ice Age. Here also the same thing.
Your 10 minutes are over.
10 minutes is about to... Okay. The another study, there are so many studies which shows with the other proxy also, that shows the medieval warm period, Little Ice Age, DSEP, and current warm period. But the difference is that the generally the climate during MWP and MCA and current warm period is warm and humid, and monsoon was increased, but the anomalous condition was also recorded. Like Sunwell et al. Have suggested ISM during the DSEP, which was a cold climate, but then they indicated intensified rainfall based on the high resolution spelethium record. But the pollen records are a bit missing. Some of the studies, like different parts of MCA, which was showing high rainfall, but Kotli et al. Has recorded MCA, which was dry also, and similarly, the Lia also shows inconsistency, and shows some warmer events, like Achutan et al. Have recorded shorter warm events during the Lia from Itanagar, Arunachal Pradesh, and there are so many records from India and South Africa from which shows some anomaly in the climatic records. Again, Yadav et al. With the help of T-ring studies, this shows some correlation, how the Roman warm period is correlated palynologically with the different studies carried out in the Indian scenario. From the Bay of Bengal also, Naidu et al. Has conducted similar study and shows the MWP and Lia. But it was the normal study, as I understand, because there was, I found no anomaly in that. But some anomalous records are also there, and which shows with the other proxies, like warm and moist climate during the MCA. However, MCA was also dry. The Singh et al. Have from the Western Himalaya, the similar way they have recorded. The dry MCA was recorded from the Lunar Lake by Prasad et al. This was the anomalous, as I found, because MCA was moist and humid and monsoon was increased. Dry Lia is common, but moist Lia was also recorded. So, in a nutshell, we can say that a strong monsoon and higher precipitation was suggested around the study area during the Roman warm period, and medieval climate anomaly and current warm period, or weak monsoon was observed during the DSEP and the Lia. So, thank you for the attention, and is there any query?
Thank you, Firoz.
Yes, sir.
Any question?
Yes. How?
This may be due to the area of a study and the monsoonal records or monsoonal precipitation that the area is receiving. Suppose from the Western Himalaya, from the Western Ghats, or from the Central India, we are recording wet MCA. But in different parts of the country, like from the Western Himalaya, some parts of Uttarakhand area, Kotli et al. Have recorded the influence of westerlies, and the MCA was dry. In the similar way, Lia was also, in normal case, it is dry. But wet Lia are also recorded, which may be due to the different effect of monsoon, or the effect of westerlies, or in Western Ghats especially, what I have studied, it is because of the influence of northeast monsoon, because Western Ghats have influence of Indian summer monsoon and the northeast monsoon also.
Okay, thank you.
Yes, yes, madam.
I got a little confused. Yes. Because is that the point that you are making is the vegetational canopy was shifting so fast.
Yes.
But that doesn't happen in real time scale. There is always a drag and a lag effect of climate, okay? And number of pollens that you showed, they are not, many of them are not indigenous to the vegetational canopy that you study there. Because since 6,000 years back, we have evidence that India was already carrying trade with the Gulf countries and also with the South Asian region, and there's plethora of work already done on it. So most of the plants that you are documenting, they need not be indigenous to the landscape. They have been invasive plants. No. Please listen to me.
Yes,
second thing is that you have matched all the spectra one over the other, okay? But that doesn't happen that you, B.S. Kotliya says something, Achutan says something, and you spectra that you take from another site and you match all that thing. It doesn't happen that way. You need to have a program which is called a spec map. You need to use that so that you can remove all these noise and then match the spectra very clearly. It looks a little haphazard. And I'm a little confused with your presentation.
Madam, I think you have two questions. One is related to the vegetation that is not indigenous. As I understand, all the vegetation that I have shown is indigenous.
Suppose I'm sorry.
Central India, except Himalaya and except pinus.
What prevents any man to come and trade in Central India?
One can train vegetation be there in the
Professor,
Central India.
Professor,
yes,
with
madam.
trade, people bring lot of seeds, they plant, things happen.
She is a very senior worker.
Yes, madam. I am listening.
Just a minute.
Yes. The point, and then you can read on it.
Yes.
But 6,000 years, everything was already established in this region, okay?
So, madam, you mean to say, sir, may I have
one? Very, very crisp.
Yes. Madam, you mean to say that the vegetation that is growing in the Central India is not from the Central India?
But the plant which is invasive.
After your presentation, when you have enough time, come and say.
Yes, sir.
Sure. I will come to you.
Okay, you can discuss. I have one suggestion.
Yes, sir.
Since you are comparing it with many workers, and then you are concluding less monsoon or more monsoon.
Yes, sir.
Since you are talking about historical time,
yes,
300 years back, 500 years back, on that location, now you have a historical data. In literature,
yes.
Whether that area witnessed any drought, whether the area witnessed any flood, if you can get it from literature, you can make another very good paper on it.
Yes, yes, sir. Historical.
And that will help you in intruding into the archaeology.
Yes.
Okay, that will be very helpful to you.
Yes, sir.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.
Give him
Thank
a
you.
Big hand. And Thank discuss you. With the Hema.
Yes, yes, yes.
You will sure. get a lot of insight from her. She's a senior worker.
Yes, yes, sir. Okay. Thank you, sir.
So this session is coming to an end, or any paper box? Firoz Khan? No. Mohammed Imtiaz? No. Krishna Kumar? No. So with that, this session get over. I will ask our senior colleague, Dr. Rasik Ravindraji, to make a final comment.
It's fine. I think we are making up the time. If those speakers whose names have been announced, they are not there, then we'll announce that the session is closed. And the organizers, please come and make any announcement if you want to make it. Anybody from the...
That's a very interesting session, and it stretched a bit long. And thank you for your patience. And thank you, sirs. Thank you, both of you. So with this, we come to an end of this session.